In this lecture, we will solve the problem related to collision between a hemisphere and a truncated wedge. Truncated wedge means part of this wedge has been cut. So this is like a triangle. If you see the cross section, this has been cut and it is placed in an inverted position and its weight is given as mg. You have a hemisphere with weight capital M. And this is how its weight will be, force will be downwards. It was moving with velocity v, and v is given as minus vi. If this I am giving just to overcome the fear of vectors. Actually, if x axis is shown in this direction and y in this direction, and velocity is given as minus vi, basically velocity is in this direction. Only thing is, it is written in terms of the coordinates. So in simple terms, in vector terms, it is like this. Simple terms, it is moving with this velocity opposite to the direction of x along the x-axis. Now it comes here and collides at a given point. Point of contact will be single. The surfaces are also considered to be smooth. We are given that the coefficient of restitution between them is 1 at the time of impact. E will be 1 means velocity of separation is equal to velocity of approach. We have to see the condition which we have to meet is that this truncated cone should neither slide along X, it should not slip, and it should also not topple. So these conditions, we have to find the relationship between velocity, and we are also given that the impact time is delta t. So we have to find the relationship in terms of velocity, mass, etc. to meet the condition such that it doesn't slip and it doesn't topple. First of all, few basic things. When the coefficient of restitution is given, it should be applied along the line of impact. Here, this is the impact line. So velocity of approach has to be taken along this line and velocity of separation also along the impact line. Now, since we are given that neither it should topple nor it should slide, means the point which is on the wedge is stationary, doesn't move at all. Vibration is neglected. So it means whatever is the velocity, if velocity of wedge is like this, v is this way, and if you have this angle as theta, if you draw like this, this angle will be theta and this angle will be pi by 2 minus theta. Sorry, this angle is theta. This is pi by 2 minus theta and this angle will remain theta. So velocity in this direction is v cos theta. This is theta, this is theta. So velocity which was in this direction, if I take along the line of motion, it is v cos theta. Since this doesn't move, so its velocity return in this direction will also be v cos theta, which means that its return velocity is also v. So initial velocity is minus vi and final velocity is plus vi. So in such cases, when you take the collision, when the line of impact, like in simple cases, if I take like two balls colliding, the impact line is parallel to the ground. So you can simply apply that if this is the reaction, r dt will be change in momentum of this one, delta p of 1, and also equal to modulus, I'm saying, I'm not writing the direction, delta p of 2. Change in momentum of this, change this, because this is the only force which is acting along the direction of velocity. You have to see the direction of velocity. So if I take this direction and try to apply this, I may commit a mistake. Because if you write n dt is equal to twice mv cos theta. Take velocity in this direction, instead of taking this direction, you take in this direction, the change in momentum will be twice mv cos theta. It was v cos theta. V cos theta reverse. Since the velocity is just reversing, it is added. So you may think of writing like this, but it is wrong because here you have missed out the normal reaction, which will also contribute to the forces. Let this be hemisphere, which will also contribute to this. This angle is pi by 2 minus theta. So it will have direction n h sine theta. So you have to take into account n minus n h dt. Only then you can write like that. Only then you can write like that. Otherwise, if you write along the impact, which is very easy in case the impact line is parallel to the ground. But here the impact line is making an angle. So do not write like this. And this is also not required. Try to use a plane. In such cases, try to use the plane which is horizontal, which is parallel to the ground. The advantage of using this plane is that whatever is the normal reaction, it doesn't contribute to the forces acting along this plane. So what is the force acting along this? If I call this plane as ZZ, it is N cos theta. And if the impact time is reaction time is dt, the impulse is n cos theta dt. What is the change in momentum of this? It is mv minus mv, because the direction is changing. So it is twice mv. Simply whenever the velocity gets reversed, the momentum is simply added. So your n delta t cos theta is this, or n is equal to twice mv upon cos theta into delta t. This is the value of your reaction which is along this line. Now your first part is done. You have found the reaction along this line. Now we have to see the two conditions. One is that let us first do the slipping part. Now for the slipping part, you should also know that there has to be some reaction, and reaction is not necessary that it has to be in the center, it can be anywhere. So reaction will be n wedge upwards is the reaction, and weight mg is downwards. It is not moving in any direction, so equate the components. This is n sine theta, this is n sine theta, this was n, and this angle is theta perpendicular, this was theta, this is pi by 2 minus theta, this is n cos theta, and this is n sine theta. So equate the vertical forces, n w plus n sine theta is equal to mg. There is no other vertical force acting on the wedge. So your Nw is equal to mg minus n sine theta. What will be the friction force? Friction force will act in this direction, which will be mu times Nw. And for it not to slip, your mu times Nw should be greater than your horizontal force which is acting on it, that is n cos theta. Put the value of Nw here, mu mg minus n sine theta should be greater than, what is the value of n? Twice mv upon cos theta into delta t. You can put the value of n here also. It is twice mv upon cos theta into delta t. So it is mu mg minus twice mv tan theta upon delta t should be greater than twice mv upon cos theta into delta t. So your mu should be greater than twice mv upon cos theta upon delta t divided by mg minus twice mv tan theta upon delta t. This is the condition for this thing not to slip at all. Now when it comes to toppling part, you have to be very careful when you deal with the toppling part. For toppling, you have to see that when the thing is about to topple, let me draw a simple diagram. If I am discussing toppling of this and some force is being applied at the critical point of, because this normal reaction keeps on shifting to take care of the rotational torque. Here you are providing a rotational torque. This is the rotational center of mass. This is your mg. This is your horizontal force. So this height is h, suppose. So your fh has to be equal to or less than this n times into this distance a. Since n is constant, n is equal to mg, there is no vertical force. The only way this avoids toppling is, since fh has to be less than mg into a, mg is not providing any torque, it is acting at center. But n is providing torque and n is equal to mg. So when you keep on increasing fh, mg cannot change but a can change. So this reaction keeps on shifting. And this is the critical point, it comes here. And it can't go beyond that, and it will topple at only this point when A becomes maximum, when FH is greater than, when FH into H is, this is into H is greater than MG times, if this is, say, whole thing is B, MG times B by 2. When this momentum of FH into H is greater than the reaction times this half of this length, then it will be toppled. So the point is, at the time of toppling, your reaction, which is vertical reaction, goes to the extreme point about which it will topple. So the reaction goes here. So this will be the point of reaction. And you have to find moment about this only at the critical point when the toppling is to be avoided. So you take moment about this. And the thing which is now, what is preventing toppling is the weight, because weight keeps on acting here only. N keeps on shifting. Now N has reached a critical position. If this is given as width W, this will be W by 2. Now you have to find this distance, which you can easily find using trigonometrical relations. This distance is nothing but the sum of these two distances. What is this distance? What is this distance? Since this angle is theta, this is normal, this angle is theta, so tan theta is equal to this distance, if I call it, say, z, or I call it e, this distance I call between these two points, this distance I call as e. Tan theta will be E upon, this is R, E upon R. So E is equal to R tan theta. So my this distance is R tan theta. And what is this distance? This distance you can find using this relationship. This is W. And this angle will again be theta. This angle is theta. So this distance will be W sine theta. This distance is W, this angle is theta, so this is W sine theta. So your this distance, which is critical point, here the reaction is acting in this direction. You have to drop a perpendicular from the reaction line to the point along which toppling will happen. Let this be O and let this be A. So OA is equal to W sine theta plus R tan theta. And the condition to avoid toppling is that your n times OA should be less than, this is the momentum being provided along O by n n times OA should be less than mg times W by 2. So what is the value of m? Value of n was twice mv upon delta t cos theta, and this is W sine theta plus R tan theta should be less than mg W by 2. So your m gets cancelled here. Your v should be less than g W upon 4 delta t cos theta divided by W sine theta plus R tan theta. So this is the condition that it should not slip. This is the condition that it should not topple. These values are not so important. What is important is the concept which I wanted to discuss. Another thing, if you have to now find what is the reaction on this floor, reaction on that floor would be equal to, now equate these forces, vertical forces acting on the hemisphere. Vertical forces are n h is in the upward direction, and what is the force in the downward direction is n sine theta plus mg. So it is very simple, put the value of n, which is twice mv upon delta t cos theta into sine theta plus mg is the normal reaction on the floor where the hemisphere is kept. One more point I would like to tell you about the collisions is that in case the impact is between center to center of two bodies, and suppose this is a dumbbell and a body collides with it like this, and this is stationary, this is M, this is M, and this is also M. You try to solve it, you will find an interesting result. Try to solve it with both the methods. One is take after the impact its velocity as V2, its velocity as V1 after impact, its velocity as V before impact, V0. Take its angular velocity omega 0 after impact. I will put a separate solution also on that, but on your own part you try. And then try to see what will happen if you treat these collisions separately. First this collision, then this part separately. You will find interesting results. Try to do it yourself. I'll be some time putting up that also.